Hey everyone, Adam with Droid Media here, and today we're going to be making one of these awesome LED tube lights. LED tube lights are all the rage right now, and today we're going to be making our very own just like this one. Now these come out to about $25 per foot if you follow the instructions that I made. The nice thing is though, you can use whatever materials fit your budget, and you can make them in whatever length you want. Here I've got an 18-inch one, and I just made a bunch of these because they fit into my light kit a little easier than the 3-foot ones that I initially made. But without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into this build. First, let's talk about the materials you're going to need. I bought two of these 1.5-inch frosted acrylic round tubes from Canal Plastics. Then you'll need a thin wooden dowel rod. I believe I used a 1/2-inch one that I picked up from my local hardware store. You'll want a 12-volt DC adapter, two end caps per tube, and then you'll need your LED strip light. I would recommend these 5-meter strip lights from Lighting Will, which are about $30 per strip. These have a 90 CRI, so the light is a fairly good quality. These strips also come with a solderless connector, so it's going to be way easier for us to build these lights. I went with a daylight balanced one here too to match my other lights. You can get whatever you want, including like RGBs or tungsten or whatever. I found that a 5-meter strip will give you just enough to fill a 3-foot tube. My strips have two bare wires on the end for us to connect to our power supply. You'll also want some extra wire, and then you'll need a few tools too, like a screwdriver, wire cutters, a hot glue gun, and a soldering iron. All of this stuff will be linked below. I actually cut my tube down to make 18-inch lights so they would fit in my Pelican cases, but you can literally make whatever length you'd like. If you decide to cut them, just use a hacksaw and then sand or file the ends down so they're nice and smooth. Cut down your dowel to the length of your tube, and then we want to drill two small pilot holes at both ends. Take your extra cord and cut a length several inches longer than your dowel rod, and tape one end to your dowel with a few extra inches of excess wire hanging out. I just used some masking tape that I had nearby. Make sure that the wire is flat against the dowel, it's tight, and then go ahead and tape that other end down too. Grab your LED strip, take the adhesive off the back, and leaving about a 1/2-inch of the dowel exposed, we want to stick it to the rod, and we want to make sure this is done at an angle. Peeling the adhesive off as you go, wind it all the way down the rod. We want the LED strips touching, but not overlapping. Now when you get to the other end, be sure to leave another 1/2-inch or so of the dowel out. And then if you need to cut your light strip, be sure to do so along the lines of one of the predetermined cut areas. Mine have a little cut icon and then a couple copper areas where I could cut them at. We need these to solder the wires to, so just cut them carefully with a wire cutter. Then strip the ends of the extra wire on the end we just cut, and we want to solder the black to the negative and the red to the positive. These should be labeled somewhere on your LED strip. If you've never soldered before, I recommend you practice on a few chunks of excess wire before doing it here, or watch one of the thousands of YouTube videos before doing it. Honestly, it's super easy. Just be careful and go slow. And just so you know, this is the hardest part of the project. After this, it is smooth sailing. After those are soldered, let's go back to the other end. Strip the excess wire here too, and then if you need to, cut and strip the wires coming from your LED strip. You'll want just under 2 inches of wire for each of these. Make sure your solderless power adapter is nearby, and then twist the two bare black or negative wires together, and then slip those into the negative side of the power adapter and screw them down. Simply repeat this step with the two bare red or positive wires. You should now have a dowel covered in LED lights with one end soldered and the other end ready to get plugged in. At this point in time, it probably looks bare and ugly, but we're gonna add those frosted tubes in just a minute and make sure it looks real sexy. Before you go any further though, make sure your connections are solid by plugging it in. For this last little bit, go ahead and grab a couple of tiny screws. I just used a handful of small ones that I had laying around. Get your end caps, your acrylic tube, and that Uggo LED stick we just made. In the end caps, you'll wanna drill two very small holes directly in the center. And then drill a larger hole in the outer edge of only one of the end caps. I believe I used a 1/4-inch bit for this one. Slide your LED stick into the acrylic tube, and then start one of the screws through the end cap without the larger hole in it. finish screwing it into the far end of this LED stick, and then slide that onto your tube. It should fit nice and snug. Then disconnect that solderless adapter at the other end, and using some hot glue or sturdy adhesive of your choice, connect it to the other end cap with the power adapter on the outside and the wire connectors on the inside. This one that you see here was the first one that I made, and it is ugly as f***. If you make more, just know that they're gonna come out prettier each time. Reconnect your wires like we did earlier, and snap that end onto the tube to seal everything up. Now go ahead and plug that super sexy, super kick-ass LED light tube in and bask in all of its wonderful glory. These lights are super easy to use. Just grab a clamp and put them to use in your next project. Be sure to subscribe for our next video because I'm gonna show you guys how to make a bank like this where you can attach different lights to it. This is gonna have an adapter on the back so it can attach directly to a light stand. And then it's also gonna have a little dimmer here as well. Also, I'm gonna be joined by my very adorable, very needy production assistant. So if you've got any questions about this build, please leave those down in the comments section below. If you've got any questions about this video or this project, leave those down in the comments section below. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and I will see you guys next time.